This is a HeadGum Podcast.
Wow. Hey, buddy. How you doing? Thanks so much for coming out tonight. So, if you listen to the podcast, first off, sorry. Second off, you know that there is a WGA strike going on right now, and thank you. By the way, while we're applauding labor, Palladium Times Square is a union venue. How about that? So because of the WGA strike, I'm not writing new intros right now, but I still wanted to do an intro because this is a live show, so here's what I settled on. I am going to do the first intro from our first New York City live show in September of 2017. Was anyone at that show? Yeah! Psycho shit. It's been 6 years. There are so many other podcasts. Okay, so here's the intro from our first New York City live show, Guy's American Kitchen with Christine Nangle. Emma, if you want to play the music. Is this my light over here? Is that better? Okay, great. Here we go. April 19th, 1993 was a defining day in the history of TV. It marked the launch of a new basic cable channel called the Television Food Network. Viewed through the prism of today's fragmented, micro-targeted pop culture landscape, it seems unremarkable. But back in 93, the TV Food Network was mocked and derided as a sign of television's descent into absurdity. Originally, its programming was targeted at elite gourmands and presented by hosts like Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous' Robin Leach, Gourmet magazine editor David Rosengarten, and Donna Hanover, the then wife of disgraced and discredited former New York City Mayor Rudy Giuliani. But as the channel evolved, it discovered a recipe for bigger ratings, scoring its first mainstream hit via New Orleans chef Emeril Lagasse, a natural on camera with his outsized personality, running list of catchphrases, and tendency to punctuate seasoning with an outburst of BAM! The new Food Network, having dropped TV from its name, centered its programming on down-home fare presented by every man and woman, amassing a stable of celebrity chefs including Bobby Flay, Rachel Ray, and the now-shunned Paula Deen. Then in 2005, Food Network launched its reality competition show, The Next Food Network Show, The Next Food Network Star, and its season 2 winner would transform the channel. A Bay Area chef with bleach blonde hair styled in Bart Simpson spikes with the piercing tattoo sleeves and flame emblazoned bowling shirt of a karaoke DJ. Guy Fieri, who'd legally changed his last name to its Italian spelling, Fieri. This dead ringer for the singer from Smash Mouth smashed the expectations of a chef. The Sammy Hagar of the kitchen. Hulk Hogan in a chef's coat. A chuggalo. And it would become not just the next star, but the biggest star in Food Network's history. Famous for both tasting and preparing over-the-top American food that often seemed conceived on a dare. Before hitting the airwaves, Fieri had already had two restaurants, Italian concept Johnny Garlic's and Tex Wasabi's, a barbecue sushi joint. Yes, you heard that right. But his hit shows, led by the travel-focused Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives, elevated his profile to expand his empire of franchises onto cruise ships and the Vegas Strip, and in 2012, he opened his flagship restaurant right here in Times Square. While embraced by tourists, it's been shunned by elitists, most famously in a scathing New York Times review where critic Pete Wells, the kind of snobbish gourmet who Food Network cast away in favor of regular guys like Guy, described one cocktail as nuclear waste that tasted like some combination of radiator fluid and formaldehyde. Fieri brushed aside the viral teardown, responding, quote, "I'm doing the type of food America loves and I'm doing it the right way." But is it really the type of food America loves? Is it actually money? Gangsta and off the hook. Will it truly make one exclaim, shut the front door or holy stromboli Batman? This week on Doughboys, we've flown cross country and landed in Flavortown, USA. It's Guy's American Grill and Bar. And this week on Doughboys, live in New York City, Gray's Papaya. Welcome to Doughboys Live. I'm Nick Weiger. How you doing, New York City? Wow. What a show we have for you tonight. But before we go any further, this week's roast is courtesy of Brian. Let me introduce my co-host, all bush, no wick, the Spoon Man, Mike Mitchell. Oh my God.
I couldn't go through with it that much. And it was so hard to get this suit here.
You look great. Mitch is dressed up as Austin Powers because, Mitch, it's this is canonically a silly show.
That's right. That means we're on fumes. We're going to be bad. Whew. Austin had a thin neck, apparently.
Mitch, that roast was sent in by Brian, who's not at the show because he's getting married. How about that?
Are you fucking coward?
My wife wouldn't let me move her wedding day so I could go see the Doughboys.
I saw it on the gram. Congrats to both of them.
Congrats.
Send her a congratulations DM.
There's another roast that was sent in, Mitch. I'm going to read this one. It's a little bit of a long road, but I think it's worth it, especially with the added context.
Okay.
I'll just read it as a roast. Please welcome my co-host, the architect of Central Pork, Brederick Slaw Olmsted.
You don't have to read every fucking roast you got.
Hi, Nick, Mitch, Emma, and Amelia. I wanted to offer this NYC-themed roast that doubled as a tribute to Frederick Law Olmsted, the landscape architect who designed Central Park and Brooklyn's Prospect Park, which I prefer to Central. Sorry you can't enjoy either of these beautiful outdoor spaces because of the current state of our air quality, but I look forward to seeing the show in NYC. Hugs and kisses, Rod O, a.k.a. O'Tooler, in the dough scored. P.S. Shout out to Team Culver's. You hear Rod O?
Hey, buddy.
Wow.
Wow. Fucking Weiger clone. The fuck? What the fuck is that guy's deal?
He seems cool to me. So, Mitch, I know you never listened to my intro, but I did ask who was here for our first show in New York City in 2017.
How long are you supposed to be able to dance like Austin Powers and not be completely out of breath? Because I'm still, I'm having a hard time breathing.
I do think north of 8 seconds, so.
Did I give up too soon?
Yeah, I mean, I think you did what you could. You look great.
What do you mean I did what I could?
You don't want to push it too far at the top of the show, because then you're going to have no energy. You're going to run out of gas.
Okay, all right. Yeah. I didn't know if you wanted more, because I would do more. No.
I mean.
No.
No one's going to complain if there's more.
You're supposed to say, no, let's move on.
No, Mitch, we simply cannot have fun on this silly show. We need to move on. We got more bullet points to get to on my outline.
Why is it? It was really smoke.
No, then you're supposed to do it anyway.
Oh.
You're supposed to get Emma to play it and do it anyway. There we go. Ooh, that impetuous Spoon Man.
Costs us like $100 to get the stupid jacket. It's too tiring.
So you ditched the jacket, and now you're just wearing the vest?
Which makes you look kind of like a New York guy over here. New York guys wear vests? They do.
No, you just look like you're doing half-assed steampunk cosplay.
Well, my breath is out again.
Okay, so I said earlier, I asked who was at the New York show in 2017. I also wanted to ask, because we met some of them at Today's Chain, who was at our DC show last night? Okay, a few people. Is anyone coming to our show in Medford tomorrow? Wow.
Breadheads.
The breadheads.
Yeah. It's like deadheads, but way more pathetic. And they don't have fun.
Yeah.
That's when I was coming in tonight, there was a guy at the front being like, Doughboys this way. And I was like, that guy doesn't know what he's talking about.
Sure.
Makes no sense. We're in Times Square, kind of.
Yeah, we're just off of Times Square,
That's
I think.
That's insane. Thank you for all being here. It's great.
Yeah, thanks for being here.
Smoky week for you guys here in New York City.
What did you say?
Smoky. Do you thought I said Snoky?
No, I just couldn't hear you.
Smoky. It's a smoky week. I'm out of breath.
It's a smoky week. The air. It was historically bad. Yeah. We were just in D.C. and it was the worst air quality day in the city's history.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It was so smoky in New York wise. You know what happened?
What's that, Mitch?
I visited the Statue of Liberty.
Uh-huh.
Lady Liberty was flipping off Canada.
So, for the overwhelming majority of you who weren't at our DC show last night, Mitch had a version of that he tried out with the Lincoln Memorial. Only, do you want to say what that punchline was?
Sure. Why? It was so smoky in DC this last week.
How smoky was it?
I went over to Lincoln Memorial. The seat was empty.
So I think that's a punch up, what you landed on.
I was just trying to address the smoke. It's topical.
My pitch was, and it's not what you want, my pitch was I went to go see the Statue of Liberty.
Uh-huh.
She was wearing an N95 mask.
You fuck, don't you dare. Don't you dare. To Spoon Nation,
wow,
in New York
there
City. Emma, should we hit him with a drop? Listen up, baby.
Just to be the man who walks 500.
They walk 1,000 miles then. Should we edit this out?
The listeners must never know I made a mistake.
We're back.
We're back, baby.
We're back.
We're back, baby.
We're back, baby.
We're back,
that's
baby.
Real. Hey, everyone. Here's another drop. Keep up the great work. Chris Finke.
Wow, Finke.
Finke. He's good.
Yeah, that guy's good.
Drop master. I forgot what we call him. Wags, how you doing?
I'm hanging in there.
Mm-hmm. New York. I love it. Came in, trained over to Gray's Papaya. I went back, slept at the hotel till now.
Wow. I wish we had more time in the city. The way this is booked, it's like we have the least amount of time in New York. And this is, I don't know, I always love visiting here for a variety of reasons.
Yeah, we got friends here, but the backstage, we got a lot of our buddies back there.
And you got the subway,
mm-hmm.
which thankfully we got to ride a little bit.
We saw Pizza Rat.
Was that actually Pizza Rat?
It was Pizza Rat. You didn't see me get my picture with him?
I saw a rat, but I didn't know it was Pizza Rat.
Remember we fought over a slice, Pizza Rat and I. Yeah, we don't got enough time. We're going to Boston tomorrow, which is a much better city, so.
Wow.
Oh! Oh, you forgot I'm from Boston? Fuck off! Yeah, so do the Knicks, kinda. I mean, if you want to put it that way, we all kinda suck.
He beat you both, right?
Yeah, the Heat beat us both.
And the Bucks.
Yeah.
What a run for the Miami Heat.
Shut
the finals
up.
Again.
What are you doing?
I don't know. It's an impressive franchise.
Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah,
what they've
great.
Done since Pat Riley left the Knicks to go to the Heat, it's been quite a run.
I feel like I should put this Austin Powers costume back on, just go into Times Square. Just continue doing it out
Get
there.
Get your ass kicked by a woman wearing a Minnie Mouse suit. This is my fucking corner. Fuck out of here. I assume Times Square is a similar territorial thing as the Hollywood.
He's getting off. That's Minnie Mouse.
He likes it.
Yeah, that's me.
Austin Powers likes getting the shit kicked out of him by a mascot performer. There,
only Minnie. That's me on the ground. I'm trying to say I get turned on when Minnie Mouse is kicking my ass.
Right.
Okay, good, good.
So, in Hollywood Boulevard, there's a similar thing as in Times Square. There's a bunch of costume performers, mm-hmm. and they're very territorial.
They are very territorial.
Yeah, I imagine the same thing takes place here. Like, you can't just show up in a Captain America costume or fucking Jack Sparrow will kick your ass.
Oh, you think Jack Sparrow will help?
What? I genuinely can't hear you. That's part of the issue.
You can't hear me?
I can't hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay.
Jack Sparrow would help if you, like, would help out Captain America. Like, you're saying that they're that territorial?
No, I'm saying if you were what you just said.
That Jack Sparrow at the end of the
podcast. This isn't even worth following. What you just said, the scenario of you dressing up as Austin Powers going out there and then Minnie Mouse are fucking going after you.
Yeah, kick my ass, I get turned on.
You uh-huh. So you figure that, you understand what the logic there,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
exact
yeah.
same principle. You just went out in a Captain America costume, someone who regularly plays Jack Sparrow there would also get mad at you for stepping on their territory.
I got it. It's a territorial thing. Got
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Okay. I love the addition of Jack Sparrow at the end of the Pirates of the Caribbean ride. I think it's a great choice.
He's still in there, right?
He's still in there.
Yeah.
He pulled it off. Anyways.
Bring him back.
Bring Depp back. This is the perfect platform to say, bring him back. Come on. I say put Amber Heard at the end of the ride, too. They were there together.
Then everyone's happy.
Everyone's
happy.
That's
a compromise we can all live with.
I can't tell if I'm sweating from dancing from Austin Powers or if it's genuine flop sweat.
It's a combo.
Combo yeah. of the two. Okay. All right.
I'm getting it too. But you know what, Mitch? We want to dig out of this ravine.
We got a great way to do
we
it.
We have a Triforce of
Are they still
now.
There?
Let's do it.
Oh, God. All right. Yeah, they're here.
Still, did they leave? Y'all ready for our guests? Let's get them out here. Make some noise for Zach Cherry, Mike Hanford, and Tammy Sager. Wow.
Hello, New York!
What the hell? Oh, my God. There's so many people here. That's
I know.
Terrifying. Jesus. Can you do that again for a second? Yeah!
Wow.
I love it.
Yeah, put it back down.
Thank you all so much for
Thank
being
you.
Here.
Thanks for having us.
Wait, I want to talk about something real quick because we didn't address this last night in D.C., Mitch. But
yes,
there was a point yesterday when you and I both were worried that Tammy had died.
That is true. We thought you died, Tammy.
And we were so concerned. Thankfully, it was obviously. It's not a fucking. Imagine if this reveal, if that was a ghost. It'd be fucking mind-blowing.
Well, has anyone tried to pass
Ghost
their hand through her yet?
Ghosts are real. And this is how I learned it at Doughboys Live.
You thought you think you go to Beetlejuice on Broadway, you see a ghost. You come to the Doughboys show, when you see one instead. All right, well.
I thought he was a...
This is why you thought there weren't a lot of people here. It was so like that. I was like, oh, it's a little...
I was shocked.
No, I overslept a shocking amount for our 12:45 meetup.
Classic right. Mitch move.
And it was and not responding to text, not responding to like a phone call, and Mitch and I were both like genuinely like really worried. Mitch had the idea to have your hotel room called.
I've been in that finally... scenario once or twice. Yeah.
You were like that happened with me once and you.
I did, yeah.
Going up to Boston.
Going to Boston. I called Hanford's room. Yeah. I can be on time sometimes. And I said to Weiger, I said it to you too. I was like, I didn't see her go to her room last night, and we were afraid that like you maybe got someone got
Wait,
you. What?
Were
you set up watching her room to see?
I walked Zach to his room. I walked Weiger to his room. I do not
it's
know.
It's also
happened
just
to
like Mitch is like a girl stood me up. She must be dead. I just overslept a shocking amount.
I was glad it was just that. Because we also talked, this was a thing we talked about, is that like...
It was smoky.
It was very smoky, yeah. And we were all like being affected by it. Yeah. And I was like,
No, that is what happened. I woke up at like 6 in the morning and then I was up for a few hours, like, and then I fell back asleep. And when I say up, I mean on Instagram. I don't mean I was up and out.
Can I do a topical smoky thing before we move too far past the smoky?
Yeah, please.
Um, It was so smoky in New York the last few days. I saw the Statue of Liberty, and instead of saying, like, bring me your tired and your poor, it was saying, like, bring me your Cheez-Its and your Hot Pockets, because it was, like, it was so smoky. It was, the Statue of Liberty was high. I don't know if you guys saw that when you were...
I noticed that.
I heard her say, bring me your salmon.
Yeah.
Smoke that salmon.
Oh, yeah.
Salmon. Yeah. Smoke salmon.
It was really, no, you guys are right. It was really hot around here the other day.
I thought it was smoky. It was hot.
It was hot and smoky.
Okay, hot and
smoky. I think the smoke was from the heat. But it was so smoky, I saw a bear with pants and a ranger hat on. And he was like, I thought that was my job. And I was like, you don't make smoke.
Yeah.
Oh, okay,
your name's Smokey.
Right.
I'm glad that you corrected him, too. Yeah. Well, hold on a second.
Didn't make any sense.
Yeah, that's wild to me.
He was a little wild himself.
I believe
wild
it.
Wild animal.
I saw that, too. I saw that,
yeah,
too.
It was... Yeah, I think it was on 8th Street.
8th Street and 8th Avenue.
God,
yeah.
Okay, all right.
We got some shouts for 8th Street. What's on 8th Street?
Smokey the Bear. He lives there. He leaves in a walk-up.
We're talking hot dogs today.
Oh, yeah, okay. I'll be quiet, Nick.
No, you're doing great.
Nope. I get it. We're talking about hot dogs today.
No, I love everything that's happened so far. I'm just saying, we're talking hot dogs.
Can you let our guy just get some jokes in, our guests?
I wrote down so many. Mitch said I could do some of them.
I'm going to start.
Yeah, you can cook a little bit.
What?
You want to cook a little bit? You can cook a little bit.
You want me to go off?
Yeah, you can cook a little bit.
Let me have a little more of my red cup and I'll go off.
Okay, all right.
Don't ever call me out on that. I got nothing here.
You got beef with Pizza Rat, don't you? You're not a fan
of
his.
He's doing well. No, I don't really know him that well, but he's doing well.
He's doing well.
I know you saw him today. He got in and out on some crypto at like the right time.
Oh, smart.
He's doing all right.
It was so smoky, he's not even Pizza Rat anymore.
Oh, shit.
He's
what is he?
He's Bacon Rat.
Oh!
I saw him in the subway this morning. He's dragging a huge piece of bacon. That's true.
Bacon Rat?
Yeah.
I saw him later. And he was dead because of the carcinogens in the air.
Oh, man.
Oh, no.
It's really bad, you guys.
Wow.
The particulates are really, it's really dangerous.
Well, he was always an anti-mask rat.
This, always. Tammy, it makes no sense he's dead. I walked him to his hole. It doesn't make any sense at all. Walked him right up to his hole. Do rats live in holes as much as they used to? I feel like that was... You know, a hole in a wall used to be, you know, used
at the
to be
baseboard.
Like a baseboard, a little
hole that the homeowner cut perfectly.
Yeah. And then when the cat goes to chase him and goes in, he comes out and his nose is the shape of the hole.
Can I be honest with you? I hated that when that happened.
Yeah. But no, I think a lot of mice now, and Weiger, I don't want to take too much time on this, but.
No, please.
I think a lot of rats and mice are living up in birds' nests these days.
Interesting.
Have you heard about that?
Interesting.
Yes. I read about that. Where did I read that?
Bird? Was it Bird Monthly or was it Rat Monthly?
It was
monthly?
Either that or... it was in Rat Monthly, but it was the Bird Monthly insert. To try to get you to... And I did. I got both of them.
Wait, is that for real?
Mm-hmm.
That's fucked up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's fucked up.
Wait, is that for real? Do rats...
That what is real? That rats are living in nests?
Well,
that
I for sure know that...
Rat Magazine.
That Rat Monthly is real.
Okay.
But do rats actually live in birds' nests?
I can't tell you what every single rat does in this city.
Okay.
I'm not New York City's new rat czar. Let's hear it.
I mean, it does feel like what would happen with housing in New York is like, it's so overcrowded, even like the birds can't sleep in their own nests.
Yep.
It's rat oligarchs are taking over.
I'll say that I'll be out with friends. I'm like, man, it's getting so crowded here. Rats are going up. They're not just rents. I don't think anyone needs microphones up here but me. This is good.
Speaking of hot dogs.
Yeah.
Ooh.
So here's the trickiness about covering hot dogs with this particular panel. First off, Zach, you're vegan.
Yes.
Vegan-ish.
Yeah.
Tammy, you don't eat hot dogs because they give you migraines.
Yeah. Oh. That's a bring the middle-aged lady onto the show and have fun with that.
And then Hanford, was that a bit or not that you're doing a keto diet?
I'm 3 weeks into a keto diet.
Wow.
This is insane.
But I ate a little bit of the bread. It was okay. I mean, it's okay that I did that. It's fine.
How are you holding up? Because anytime I've tried to do low carb, there reaches a certain point where I'm just like get so fatigued by it. Not more mentally than anything. I'm just get so bored by what I can choose from to eat.
Yeah, there's a lot of that. There was also just like the first week I was like dead tired all the time, and I read that that's like you get out of it. Mm-hmm. Now I've got all the energy in the world.
Wow.
And how do you get over the exhaustion of only talking about being on keto while you're on keto?
Well, this is the thing. I've got so much energy now with the great foods that I'm eating that I don't slow down when I talk about keto.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
I'm happy for you doing keto, whatever. sorry, I shouldn't be dismissive. I am happy
That's
for
okay.
you. I got to say, Zach, I told you we were doing a completely different restaurant.
You did, but it was a barbecue restaurant, so it wasn't wasn't really a lot better.
I said today when he showed up, hey, we're doing great, sorry. He said, I saw on Twitter.
Yeah.
No one informed you.
No.
Oh,
no, it was really my fault.
Although I think Amelia informed me. I think Amelia did invite
me. Okay. All right, good.
Well, you mentioned a barbecue restaurant, and this is what I was advocating for. I acquiesced. I allowed us to cover Gray's, which I am a fan of, and we'll talk about in a second. But there's a place I really love in New York City, and I think some people have some affection for, called Dallas BBQ. Look. Is
booze.
It good?
It's got booze.
Is it good? No, but it's fun. And it's fun to go to Dallas Barbecue when you're in New York City and there's so many other great food options. It's fun to make that choice, especially if you're visiting from out of town. And so I've been to Dallas Barbecue more than once. And you know what? I have a fucking blast at the time of my life.
I do. I think you made the bolder choice of going to a chain that has only one location.
Down to one location, yeah.
That was the thing I was most surprised by. When you said you were going Gray's, I said, which one? And you said, there's only one.
There's one left.
It's the Highlander of Gray's Papaya.
There's one left. And also, on that note, Nicholas Gray, who founded Gray's Papaya, passed away in May of this year, just a couple short weeks ago. Yeah.
Right when you announced that we were doing Gray's Papaya.
Time to go.
The last thing they found on his phone was the tweet announcing it. Just him looking at it.
Gray's Papaya was opened in 1973, originally as a franchise of Papaya King, and then went independent in 1975. Now, here's the thing. My naive POV, I really thought Gray's was the original, but this is a Hydrox Oreo situation where Papaya King launches first, as Hydrox launched first, Oreo clones it, Gray's Papaya clones it, and then that becomes like the more ubiquitous brand and the more iconic brand.
A bad name, though, Gray's Papaya.
Hard disagree. It's a great fucking name.
It's great.
It's a great name.
How do you like Gray King? Do you like Gray King?
I like the Gray Man on Netflix. Like everyone here, I fucking saw it. I bought all the merch.
No, you don't like it?
Waiting for a physical release. We all had Gray Man fever. The Russo brothers' original IP that they did with all their accumulated clout from making so many Marvel movies. They made the fucking Gray Man, and you know who loved it? America.
Like I said, Gray King. Gray is not a gray.
Gray is great. Gray's Papaya. His name is Gray.
Gray food, Gray's though. Papaya. Gray food is not super appealing.
That's what I'm
People
saying.
People don't want gray food.
What would you? What color would you want it to be called?
Yellow papaya.
Yeah, that's not
bad name.
That's
Why?
Pee,
man.
That's
the
worst
piss.
Name. Name fucking sucks.
Is Yellow worst. Is piss.
Yellow
Hammer
is
dry.
Piss.
So and brown,
we know
brown's papaya is definitely out the window.
Brown's brown papaya.
Brown's poop.
Green is puke.
Green's puke, shit. White's cum.
White's right, we cum. Don't
Red also can be cum.
That's also...
Right.
No.
It
That's
can
true.
Be.
No.
Zach,
it can
you might
be.
Want to make an appointment with your doctor.
Can I share something truly filthy that from fourth grade?
Oh my God.
Something truly filthy from fourth grade.
So in fourth grade.
From a fourth grader, or were you also in fourth grade?
I was also in fourth grade.
Okay, cool, good, good. Cool.
That was today. Okay.
Just on what Zach just said. In fourth grade, this kid Larry came up to me, and I guess I was there to settle a debate because I was kind of like, oh, you're like the smart kid in class or whatever. That's my assumption. He I know stuff. And he came up to me and is like,
Because you're like 37.
Yeah.
They came up and said, Mr. Weiger,
yeah,
please.
Settle this for us.
Let's learn our timetables. So he came up to me and he's like, Nick, don't you have to piss blood in a girl's pussy to get her pregnant? And I said, no, actually, no, it's sperm. And he goes, sperm is blood. Don't you know that? Yeah. I felt so owned.
That guy taught me health education.
I remember talking with a friend, Claire, in like seventh grade. It was like sex ed. And it was like the penis enters the vagina. And then we were like, so why does it take so long? We're like, it enters, and we didn't realize there was movement once the entering happened.
You thought it was more like an interlocking system. Click it into place.
Like you enter and then you exit. Like, why are you in the revolving door so long?
So we have to get back. Wait, he said, sperm is blood. That's what he said.
Sperm is blood. Don't you know that?
They actually taste very differently, buddy.
Jesus Christ.
What? What do you want from me?
Not that.
I found flavored condoms in my dad's cabinet.
Hell yeah. What flavor? Wow.
I think it was like green apple. They didn't taste good.
He sees you like come downstairs with a green tongue, and he's like, I don't want to ask him because I don't admit that I am. I don't know where that came from.
Blowing a giant bubble. When do they do that in? When do they eat condoms and blow big bubbles? Oh, cone heads. Oh, the fucking cone heads. They're nasty little fuckers, the cone heads. Tammy, you get headaches when you eat hot dogs?
I'm wrapping my head around the flavored condoms.
No, I know. No, it's a lot. It's a lot to see. It's a lot to see.
It's a lot. It's a lot to digest.
It's a lot to, yeah.
Did you taste more than one to see if it was consistent across?
Wait, and how old were you?
This is like the last year of his life. No, I was like 10 years old.
But you knew what they were.
Yeah, maybe 12 years old, okay. But I knew that they were.
And then were you like, so pussies can taste things, or did you understand what the ramifications? Anyway, I get migraines, which are different than headaches. They're kind of completely flat in you.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's like a curse.
It's shallow.
The great reference Shallow Hal, which is held up very well.
Did you get one today?
No. The first time I ate a hot dog and it happened, not my fault. The second time I ate a hot dog and I got a migraine, a little bit. That's on me. The third time I ate a hot dog and fully got a migraine, I was like, okay, I get it. I'm a fucking dick. So no, today I did the Weiger and got the bun.
Yeah, it's a power move.
Power move.
Were you mad I brought up Shallow Hal?
No, I wasn't sure. Is there a migraine subplot in Shallow Hal?
No, I'm just saying that like if he did that to me, I'd be, you know, Tony Robbins in the movie.
Wait, what?
Tony Robbins
Wait a minute, what do you mean?
In the movie, 8 foot lurking over Mitch. And he's
like, hot dogs will give you migraines. That's what I'm saying. It's like a curse in a way.
Oh.
Was Shallow Hal the best way to get there? I don't know.
I just don't think... A lot of people on the panel here know that much about Shallow Hal.
You can't get by referencing Shallow Hal anymore. You got to reference something ubiquitous, like the gray man. We got gray man fever, right?
Woo! I wish I could Shallow Hal myself.
Oh, Mitch, no.
What does See, that mean that to you?
No, you're beautiful outside and in.
No, I wish I could tell. I wish Tony Robbins was shallow, man.
That movie is itself shallow. It's saying that, like, you know, people are only, like inner beauty doesn't reflect outer beauty or whatever, you know?
Wait,
like,
so
no,
you want to see people...
You're beautiful as you are.
You want to see people differently?
No, I want to see me differently.
I don't think you've seen the movie.
He doesn't see himself differently.
He sees other people differently.
I've definitely seen that trailer. Tony Robbins is in it.
Yes.
Yeah, he is in it.
So is Jack Black. Okay.
Yes. Yep.
Yes. Settled.
Star of the movie is in it. Went independent in 1975, launched the Recession Special in 1982, had about a half dozen locations at its peak, but now down to just one because of rising rents. Perhaps the same rents that are driving birds.
Rats.
Birds are leaving,
and
I guess.
And rats into the...
Where the hell are birds going?
That I don't know either, but one could only guess that they live on top of the tallest buildings here. I don't know.
I did have a bird live on my air conditioning as of last week.
Wow.
But then one morning, I heard some noise, and its nest was destroyed, and it was gone.
Whoa.
Oh, my God.
Was there a cat down in the alley with a big stomach going, ooh, I've never eaten so good.
Yeah, there was a cat... There was a cat down in the alley with a big stomach.
Yeah. Hey, here's something funny. You know, in cartoons, you'd see like a cat like in the alleyway on top of a fence, like singing, and like someone would throw a boot at it.
Oh yes, yeah, that's a classic Heathcliff gag.
The other night in my apartment, I heard a cat like wailing outside, and I was like, "Oh, this is what they must have done a long time ago a lot, and this is why people throw their shoes at them."
Did you get a boot?
No. It went away eventually. But okay. I was like, oh, this better not be happening for the next
month. You know what's going on there.
Yeah, I don't think they're singing.
Either I think they're either... I think I can guess
it's
what they're
doing. It's a lady cat.
Uh-huh.
And she wants to fuck.
She was eating flavored condom. Let's leave it at that.
Oh.
They got to remake Kong. They should remake Kong and put all the birds on top of the Empire State Building.
They should have him pick them. All the birds in New York City carry Kong away.
That's a great ending.
That would be fun.
To King Kong, that's a great alt ending.
How about it's the beginning of a movie where then he goes to a different island and we see what he gets up to?
I think that would be great.
Let's do it. When this strike's over, we're going to write that movie.
Look, I don't know how you guys feel, but I'm having a great time up here.
We're having fun up here.
Yeah, this audience is fucking dead. Let's go, people.
You're in fucking Times Square, dude. I'm going to get Joe's Pizza after this. Is it open late?
Well, now everyone's going to go there and try to see you.
I tricked you. I'm going to go to... fuck.
The Cake Boss Shop.
The Cake Boss Shop.
The M&M right? store.
What's that?
You go to the M&M store.
I'll go to the
actually,
M&M store.
You might actually go. Never mind. No. There's a lot that's open in Times Square.
Yellow. Can I get a picture with you? Yeah, sure.
Another one. Yeah, the other ones, Weiger's finger were in it. I got a selfie stick, though. We can do it now.
Our next partner is Athletic Greens. I take AG1 by Athletic Greens literally every day. I gave AG1 a try because I wanted better gut health and immune system support, but I hated taking pills, vitamins, and wanted a supplement that actually tastes great. I take AG1 in the morning before starting my day, and it makes me feel like I'm doing something good for my body, like I'm giving my body the nutrition it craves. It's hard for me to keep up with a supplement routine that comes with a bunch of different products, but AG1 makes that so much easier. AG1 was designed with ease in mind so you can live healthier and better without having to do a lot. It's the healthiest thing you can do in under a minute. AG1 is powerful because it's so easy to fit into your lifestyle. It's one scoop of powder mixed with water once a day. AG1 has been part of millions of mornings since 2010. AG1 gives you increased energy and mood support, making it easy to live your best life. You know the thing about AG1? It's delivered to me and to you every month. So it's super easy to make it a daily habit. And also, they got the single serving travel packs. So you're hitting the road, you don't have to miss a day. Just pour that powder in ice cold water and drink it in the morning. Taking care of your body each day is that simple with AG1. If you're looking for an easier way to take supplements, Athletic Greens is giving you a free one-year supply of vitamin D and 5 free travel packs with your first purchase. Go to athleticgreens.com/doughboys. That's athleticgreens.com/doughboys. Check it out. I've always thought about taking some trips down to Mexico. And if you have an upcoming summer trip abroad, my go-to travel hack is Babbel. Whether you're a seasoned traveler or embarking on your first adventure, communication is key to fully experiencing a new culture. That's where Babbel comes in. Babbel is the language learning app that sold more than 10 million subscriptions. Thanks to Babbel's addictively fun and easy bite-sized language lessons, there's still time to learn a new language before you reach your destination. I've taken some Babbel lessons in Spanish, and hey, already feel a little bit more comfortable with the language. With Babbel, you only need 10 minutes to complete a lesson, so you can start having real-life conversations in as little as 3 weeks. Babbel's expertly crafted lessons are built around real life. You learn how to have practical conversations about travel, relationships, business, and more. Other language learning apps use AI for their lesson plans, but Babbel lessons were created by over 150 language experts and voiced by real native speakers, not computers. Their teaching method has been scientifically proven to be effective. With Babbel, you can choose from 14 different languages. Plus, Babbel's speech recognition technology helps you to improve your pronunciation and accent. There are so many ways to learn with Babbel. In addition to lessons, you can access podcasts, games, video stories, and even live classes. Plus, it comes with a 20-day money-back guarantee. Start your new language learning journey today with Babbel. Right now, get up to 55% off your subscription when you go to babbel.com/doughboys. That's BABBEL.com/doughboys for up to 55% off your subscription. Babbel, language for life. So we took the choo-choo up from D.C., and we went to Penn Station. Tammy, you are our able guide. You got us on to the 1-2-3 line. One of those. I think we ended up on the 2, actually.
I did get to enjoy watching you guys go through the turnstile with bags.
Very stressful.
Could not figure it out.
Very, very difficult.
It was bad. My arm almost was broken.
It was. You just have to slide them out first, and they were just like trying to go in with it at the same time.
You know what I'll do? If I'm traveling and I come up on one of those turnstiles, I leave the suitcase. I'm
gone. You leave everything?
I'm gone. I go to LaGuardia or JFK. I don't need that type of stress. If I'm going on vacation, no way.
Two stops on the express line up to the 72nd stop, and then we got out there and we got the we took our fucking luggage and we went straight to Grace Papaya, saw a few listeners there, and we got ourselves some meals. And I think let's just each individually talk about what we got. But I got the recession special. You get 2 francs as part of the recession special. I am eating hot dogs here because I feel like that's part of the experience. And I'll just say that I've had Grace,
as opposed to the month of hot dog championship, was not part of the experience then.
No. There I felt my commitment to No Meat Shall I Eat overrode the hot dog theming back in, what was that called?
God knows.
Dog Dough Bark Fest?
Dog Dough Bark Fest.
Sorry.
A month-long grillabration of hot dogs and pet dogs. That's what it was.
That's right, yeah.
So I was like, I want to have it here because I've had Gray's and I've had Papaya Likes a ton. Me and Natalie's first exposure to it was actually Chelsea Papaya. Any Chelsea Papaya fans? Few of us. Smattering of applause. And then I've been to Papaya King. I've been to Gray's Papaya before. There's one other I've been to. What the fuck it's called? Papaya Paradise or something like that. I've been to a few of them. There's a bunch of them. And I always like this concept. I like this pairing of like a kind of shitty hot dog with like kind of chili. I'm saying this affectionately, with like chili and cheese. And that's what I got. One with chili and cheese, one with mustard and onions. And then I also got a pina colada because you get your choice of fruit juice. I think like the salty and the sweet is like the perfect pairing. I had a fucking blast eating this. I love this. I love that this exists.
Nice.
Chelsea Papaya owned by Chelsea Clinton or no? Can I sell some adrenochrome in the basement, Chelsea? Please, come on, please.
Bill, come down here and help me stir.
God, that's the best Hillary Clinton.
Come on, Bill.
Chelsea's not there.
She just lets her parents run the place.
She'll get there. She'll get there.
But no, she's not. In this particular moment, she's not. But socks is meow.
Big old belly on socks.
I want to say another thing that's pro
Howl the Cats.
Pro Grace Papaya, and I want to hear from the rest of the panel.
we got dogs for the five of us plus Emma. So, you know, six sets of hot dogs plus juices. Mm-hmm. And the total was $42.85 wow. before a tip. That's an incredible value.
A great deal.
Yeah, that's I don't know. I mean, just like a notoriously expensive city that there's still something that, like, you know, the working class can afford than everyone can enjoy. I don't know. To me, that's a huge plus.
I was also really impressed that there were a ton of people working there.
Yeah.
It was so fast. Like, especially now where every place is so understaffed and, like, they're not cutting corners with labor.
I don't know what was snappier, the service or the Franks themselves.
Huh? Confused by that reaction.
It has the cadence of a joke. Yeah. It's something. Thank you.
I guess it's not a story about how King Kong should change.
Franks have snap. Mitch, you are a...
Wags?
Yeah.
I got a three-dog knife.
Wow.
I need some ketchup and some relish.
Is that three
Wrong
dog knife?
Wrong band.
Fuck!
You're thinking of Creedence Hot Dog Water Revival.
Now we got him going.
There we go. Yeah.
That'll wake him up.
Fuck!
I got some onions and some kraut.
It's not worth
Oh,
it
no.
Anymore.
Did you think of that ahead of time?
No. That was on the spot completely.
Okay, good.
Okay.
Expertly trained improviser? Yes, that can.
What is the three dog night? Joy to the world.
Oh, fuck. That's
dog
tough.
In the bun.
God damn it.
I want another one. Add me some mustard and some ketchup.
All right, shut the fuck up.
Dogs for me and you.
Also, expertly trained in improv.
You do this to me all the time.
Well, I'm good.
At least you have your sulking vest on. You're like,
yeah, the vest is really funny.
You're like properly dressed for pouting.
It's Velcro. It's hard to take off.
Why didn't you just wear the Austin Powers garb the whole time? People were having fun. People liked it.
I know. It's a silly show.
I'll
go put it on. Okay, I'll go.
It's a silly show.
One more dance. One more dance. One more dance.
One more dance.
One more dance.
One more dance.
But a different dance. Try a different dance, Mitch, in front of the stage so everyone can see your feet.
Hit it, Emma. I don't know what to do.
Woo! Woo!
Damn.
My thighs were burning.
Perfect.
Oh, God, I really thought you were booing for real.
I'd say add Austin Powers to with Shallow Hal to the list of movies you haven't seen. What was that? What dance was that?
I don't know.
But last night's pandering was drinking a shot of Mambo, like, sweet barbecue sauce.
Yes.
So this is much healthier pandering.
That's true. Mitch, you got a three-dog night. Three hot dogs.
Yeah.
Do you want someone else to go?
Yeah.
All right, Zach, to my left, you pulled off the ultimate power move. Tell everyone what you did.
Oh, man.
I went with the Weiger Bun Classic, but I supplemented that with a pocket dog that I brought from home. I grilled up I forget the brand, but some veggie dog, wrapped it in tin foil, took the train 1 hour from my apartment.
You were an hour away?
Yeah, it's about an hour.
Oh, my God.
Still warm when I got there because I really doubled and tripled up on the foil. They gave me my bun. I slapped the pocket dog on there. And then I also had the papaya juice and the pina colada.
Impressed by your ingenuity. What did you think?
I liked it all. Although all the juices were milkier than I anticipated.
Yes.
I thought it was a papaya juice, like pure, but it was more of a creamy situation.
No, it has some dairy in it.
Weiger got there before us. So.
Okay.
But we did get to enjoy, like, there were a bunch of folks who were here tonight, which were awesome, and they were so sweet, and they were so sweet talking to you guys. But then Zach also had somebody recognize him, and it was like, hey, it's that guy! But not to you, to his, and then just really ate cement in a really satisfying.
He almost died.
And I did not acknowledge it.
Because he also wasn't saying it to, like, hey, it's that guy. It was more like, the freak show!
Yeah. Yeah.
But then he really, was
saying pretty that. Standard interaction for me. I wish I could shallow hell myself.
No, don't say that.
It does feel like you guys think it's a movie about suicide when you say it.
Dude, my boy shallow held himself last night.
Bill talking about Epstein.
Shut down the restaurant for the day, Hillary.
Bill, why? All right, Mitch, are you recovered?
Yeah.
Good. Can you talk through your three dogs?
Yes, I can talk through the three dogs. One, also, I'm going to start doing pocket dogs for myself. I think it's a great move.
It's great.
Two, I guess just for any time I need them, I'm going to do it.
It really did hold up well. I was shocked. It was still crispy and warm an hour later.
It looked
fucking
good as hell.
Kicks ass. Yeah, when we said goodbye to you, because we were only with you for like 30 minutes maybe.
Yeah.
You went back an hour?
No. I went and saw the Spider-Man movie for the second time. Because the last time I saw it, I fell asleep for a lot of it. And this time I fell asleep for different parts. So I'm now about two-thirds of the way through the movie, and I'll finish it up on my next viewing.
You know what this pocket dog thing is making me think? Mitch, you should wear a like bandolero of hot dog, like cocktail hot dogs.
That's good.
That's pretty funny.
To what?
Whatever. I mean, I don't know.
One of these wherever fucking shows. I don't know.
Yeah, that's good. I will. I'll do it.
All right.
That'd be funny.
Well, I'll tell you what I got for hot dogs here, Hamper. You want to pay attention?
Yeah.
I got myself
I'll pay attention.
A chili and cheese dog, the Sonic.
Yeah, hell yeah.
The Hedgehog.
Ooh, this guy's...
Only thing hotter than tails.
Wait, what? You say only thing hotter than tails?
Yeah, I mean, that's from Sonic's POV.
Sonic
what?
Sonic is horny
Sonic
for tails?
Says, I don't know. It could be.
I'm going to be honest with you. I think that was a mistake, what you said out loud.
He does have it written down, though.
The only thing hotter than tails?
From Sonic's point of view, you said? So he says, I'm the only thing hotter than tails?
No, the chili cheese dogs.
Chili cheese dogs.
Which he famously
He
covets.
Wants to fuck tails?
Oh, maybe.
Or he wants to fuck the chili cheese dog, or he wants to eat tails.
These are all interpretations.
Does tails have two assholes is my question. He's got two tails.
I think it's one hole.
Just one hole?
Yeah.
Okay, I one will hole take total. Your word for it.
One hole. It's a cloaca situation. One hole.
So one in one, and out. One hole connects them all.
Yeah.
One hole to bind them.
So also, none of you have seen Shallow Hal, but Jason Alexander has a tail.
He has a tail, a short little tail.
That's true. Mm. A vestigial tail.
He puts on like a different accent throughout the whole movie. Or is that the way he really talks?
I don't know.
He does something.
You haven't also seen Shallow Hal.
Oh, I've seen Shallow Hal. Come on.
Help me here, buddy.
We do the Farley Brothers marathon. We start with Shallow Hal. We end with Green Book.
Yeah, we start when they're getting good, we start.
Okay, chili cheese dog. What else did you get? And how'd you like it?
What the hell?
Get back on track. Let's get back on track. I derailed this.
Why? It's the silly show. We're supposed to have fun. All right. I got onions and sauerkraut mm-hmm. on another dog.
Right.
Ooh.
And then on the last one, I got ketchup, mustard, relish, onions.
Wow.
Nice.
And I took a bite of one of your dogs.
That's right. Yeah. We'll get to that in a second.
Okay.
Do you guys, when you guys ever...
Stay tuned for that twist.
When you guys go to places to eat, do you ever come across this type of guy who's like, say you order that,
yeah.
a type of person who's like, that's a pro order. Do you ever like those people? Yeah, this guy knows how to order.
I'm such a sucker for when my order is complimented.
Me too.
I love it.
I like it a lot too.
Yeah.
What I do, I'll go to restaurants sometimes and be like, hey, what do you like better, the, you know, A or B? And then they'll say B. I go, okay, I'll give me A. Just to fuck with them.
Wow.
Just to let them know who's boss.
I have a quick question for you.
Yeah.
Well, when I go into a restaurant, it is a war zone. Go ahead, Mitch.
Why do you do that?
Probably self-esteem issues.
So some of these papaya likes have fries, Chelsea, but this one does not. Grace Papaya does not have fries.
Oh.
No fries. It's just dogs and juice. No, I like fries. I'm not happy by the absence of fries. I'm a big fries fan. I get fries all the time.
Okay, all right.
I'm a fry guy. I think I don't like fries.
You didn't ask if they had fries.
Well, I knew they didn't have fries going in, but
that's
if they
why
had fries,
so
I would have them. I would order
going,
them.
Like
no, I would. No, I like the place.
Canonically hate fries.
I don't hate fries. Fries are, in fact, my favorite potato preparation.
And
I'm not.
But then you saw all the toppings, and you're like, yeah. "Ooh, look, they're hot! Those hot veggies. Can I get them in a bowl?"
I don't like hot salad. I do like fries. Mitch, you got
don't
three hot
break
dogs.
Children, everything you're saying is the opposite. They're all
Sonic
equally
Tails
fun.
Sonic Tails is hot to Sonic. Okay.
And Sonic is hot to me.
I did three dogs, and I thought it was a good order. I didn't yeah. feel like I was like completely stuffed.
Right.
I did go home and took a 2-hour nap. Yeah, they're not huge.
You were traveling.
No, they're not huge.
They're
good size.
They're pretty big.
Oh.
Oh, boy.
They did peek out over the bun a little bit, right?
They did peek out over the bun.
I like that. We were talking about that.
I like that's a lot of fun.
Sticks out the end.
Wish I could shallow how myself for that reason.
Zach, did you order just
look
a
at the
bun?
Mercy
you
hanger?
Said, can I have a bun? Or
I got
you?
Bun with kraut and relish. And they gave me an insane amount of both.
So much. Because
they didn't realize you were going to slip a secret dog.
They gave me probably half a cup of sauerkraut. Like, seriously.
No, I had they made a hot dog out of sauerkraut.
Yeah.
And that's what you got, Tammy.
I got that sauerkraut, relish, and onions too.
How was it though? As like a sandwich?
It was fine.
It was
better than it had any right to be. And also, I love they didn't blink when we said
no.
we wanted those things.
No, they don't give a shit.
It was awesome. They were so like, this is the least weird thing that we've seen. Is you going into a hot dog place where that's all we serve and saying, I don't want hot dogs.
In fact, you said to him, you were like, I'm going to get a dog. You can charge me for the dog. And he was like, no. He's like, we have a rule in place to what? Like, remember, he was like, no. He said, no, he's not going to charge you for the
dog.
Really? Yeah.
Oh, no. I so wasn't paying attention because I wasn't paying. So I was like, you can charge them for a hot dog.
You may have been distracted by the guy next to us who was like, are you guys in line? And we're like, yeah, we're in line. He's like, well, it usually starts here. We're like, well, it's different now. So it gets to the end of the line.
It's different, you fucking nerd.
I don't know what he was. He's like, are you all together? We're like, yeah.
He's like, oh, you all have friends. Okay, yeah. I don't know what to do.
Is there room for any more friends? Perhaps I can join you on stage tonight if you do that type of thing.
Let's bring him out.
No, I didn't want this to happen. Hello, Doughboys.
Yeah, it was shockingly good. It was shockingly good.
I'm glad that worked out for you. And what did you do juice-wise?
I did the papaya.
What'd you think?
It was fine. It did. It just tastes like it. It all tasted like second grade. Including the drink.
Wags knows that flavor.
Okay.
Oh, God. All right.
It took me like 30 seconds to get there. Sorry. I should have been quicker.
I feel like I've gone so hard at it. I'm sorry.
No, you're doing great. We're having fun. This is fun.
It's
this
a
is fun
silly
for
show.
Me. This is fun for all
no,
of us.
No, it's fun. What are you talking about?
We're having fun.
Yes.
Everyone's having fun here except for people who paid to be here.
Yeah.
Weiger, I'm really sorry I said you like hot salad. I know.
No,
that.
It's
that's,
no problem. It's
not
fine.
Cool.
This is fun.
It's not. That's probably triggering for people.
No, it's fine. Handman Todd, let's talk it through your day. Give us your dog a breakdown.
I had two hot dogs, and I had one with.
That was cool as hell.
That was fucking sick.
Cheese.
Okay, and the audience is like, hey, maybe he's Wagger right. What the fuck? Hey, maybe Wagger's right. Like, well, you pay to come see the show, then you see Hanford do the fuck. Do it again. That's good.
Yeah, anyway, so I had the. Well, I'll be doing that all night. Okay, all right. That's cool. I'll do it all the time. I had cheese. Then next to the cheese, I had they put on some onions. And then the other one I had, what was the other one? It was chili and sauerkraut. Double. Yeah, they were weird combos. I kind of freaked. I was like, duh, those two and then those two. Get me out of here. And then I had the papaya drink, which I didn't love. But I really liked, I had a sip of your coconut champagne, which was really good.
Coconut champagne I got as a round two, which was delightful. The pina colada was my favorite. And also the orange drink, Mitch, which you
yes,
got as a supplementary
juice. You went coconut, so you got two coconut drinks.
I did.
Were they alcoholic? I only took a sip, and I couldn't
tell. No alcohol. Yeah. Yeah, the papaya drink is so creamy.
I feel like I really submarine the energy with my list.
No, you're doing great.
No, I did.
Your props would have made everyone go nuts.
I know, but now they're dead. I would.
Like, no, they're like waiting for the pop.
Yeah, maybe it's a self-esteem thing.
No, it's all the it's like Pringles can.
Yes.
Get this guy on the Pringles campaign already, would you?
God, if they would just pay me in Pringles.
Well, don't
start negotiating there.
Huh?
You should ask for money.
We can only go up.
So the papaya drink, as I was tasting it, I was like, it kind of tastes like a sweet macaroni and cheese sauce.
Wow, interesting.
You said this to me right off the bat.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I think that's pretty accurate, honestly.
Because of the creaminess, maybe?
Yeah, because it's so creamy.
I don't know about that.
You know what? I agreed with you there. I was like, yeah, but now hearing it, I'm like, no, it doesn't.
That's just you reacting to everyone else's reactions. Because now you can turn against me. You thought it was a good characterization. And Emma thought it was, too.
Oh, God, are you guys going to fight?
No, we won't.
No
fight.
More
We're not
going to
fight. We're not fighting anymore. We're
you
done
know,
fighting.
You know I heard that episode.
I know.
What did you
I heard that episode.
Yeah,
I haven't heard the fight
I heard
episode.
400.
We're done
Ooh
fighting.
Boy.
We're not fighting anymore.
Now, a lot of people don't realize that I may have downloaded that episode.
Whoa.
Don't you dare try to sell that.
Somebody already, like as soon as the episode with Susser aired, somebody got into my DMs and was like, hey, I hear you have the tape. Can I buy it? Can you, not buy. It's just like, can you send it to me? I was like, nope. I did bring a clip, if we want to do that.
Is this real?
Wait, really?
I picked a little clip of what I thought was the most intense moment.
Wow.
Did you really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Do we want to hear it, folks?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I got so nervous when you guys were taking a run, I was listening to it, and when I heard you guys say, like, oh, yeah, we're gonna delete it off the Dropbox or the server or whatever. I was like, fuck, did I download that? And I ran home and I was like, oh, I did. That's how I listened to it. I downloaded it. So I snipped out a little fun, little fun part.
Eat shit, Wagga, you asshole.
What is the big deal?
Stop making fun of me on the text thread.
Okay, Spoon Man is getting upset. I better be careful here.
Yeah, you better be careful. Or me, Micus, Wu-Tang, Frailbot, Frinkbot, Autobot, I gotta kick your ass.
I think I would actually do very well in a fight against you, Mitch. I'd play dirty, and I'd punch you in the crotch and gouge out your eyeballs.
Oh, fuck you, Wagga, you could not.
Boys, please stop fighting.
Get out of here, Emma. This has nothing to do with you. I'm gonna finish this once and for all, Wagga.
Oh, I can't bear to watch. Oh, you shot Nick.
Oh, no. I killed my co-host and best friend in the world. How random of me. I feel completely choogy for this one.
Tell Natalie that I love Sonic the Hedgehog.
I love your wigs.
Wow.
It was too much.
Yeah.
I'm glad you guys didn't release it. It was too much.
It was tough to relive that. It was very intense.
It's funny that... That is a part of the fight, is in there.
Yeah. But I think it's what Evan talked about.
Okay, yeah. I said that I could beat you up, and we talked about that for a little while. When did you do that? And also, why did you do it?
I'm a creative guy with a lot of time on his hands. As I was listening to it, I said, I should not have done that.
No, I loved it.
That was fantastic, but there really was a moment of panic, of real panic, before it started that I saw... In Mitch's little, tiny little eyes.
I saw the table lift up a few inches.
That's how Weiger's standing desk works.
All right.
The truth is, no, I did not download it. But and when I did hear you guys say, oh, we should delete it, I was like, fuck, I should have downloaded that.
Weiger, when Weiger wants his standing desk to go off, he just Googles a picture of tails.
All right.
8 inches.
8 inches.
Guys packing heat down there, I'll tell
Way
you.
Way to go, Natalie.
Let's let's get to our That's fork disgusting. Scores here.
I apologize for that. I know he's not responding to it because he's probably red hot on the inside. I'm sorry. Well, that's not nice, Weiger, to say. Sometimes it's you know, I get a little caught up in the fun.
This is where we're having a blast. Let's get to our fork scores.
I might not make it back from Boston. I could end up in a Cold River situation. Cold River, was that a movie?
Mystic River?
Mystic River.
Is there a real Mystic River?
Yeah, of course.
Really?
You think they fucking made it up?
I thought it was just for the movie.
No, it's Mystic. It's Mystic.
Wow.
I'm thinking, I'm conflating a cold mountain.
Oh, what?
So I was thinking Cold Mountain and Mystic River. I was putting them together.
Mystic River is real. I'll show it to you, Wags. You can see the bottom of it, my man. Fucking toss you in that shit like Frankenstein.
Wait, Weiger can't get too close to water, though. Be careful.
That's a great point. We don't want you to short. Oh fuck. Short.
You
short.
Short circuit.
Short.
Short circuit.
Short. Yeah. Good. Okay. Good. Moving on.
This episode is sponsored by BetterHelp. You know, when I think about the scales that balance out how I budget my time in a given week, I'm probably spending more on other people than I am on myself. It's easy to get caught up in what everyone else needs from you and never take a moment to think about what you need from yourself. I do that. I'm always needing things for myself. But do I get them? Do I give them? Not always. But when we spend all of our time giving, it can leave us feeling stretched thin and burned out. Therapy can give you the tools to find more balance in your life so you can keep supporting others without leaving yourself behind. Personally, I've benefited from therapy. A lot of people I love have as well. And there are broader benefits, which I'm happy to talk about in my own words, like learning positive coping skills, how to be the best version of yourself, and it's not just for those who have experienced major trauma. If you're thinking of starting therapy, give BetterHelp a try. It's entirely online, designed to be convenient, flexible, and suited to your schedule. Just fill out a brief questionnaire to get matched with a licensed therapist and switch therapists at any time for no additional charge. Find more balance with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/Doughboys today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/Doughboys. So, guests, all veterans of the show, you know how this works. We'll each go down, give a closing army, if you will, on this particular chain, Grace Papaya, and give it a score from 0 to 5 forks. A New York institution. Zach Cherry, we'll begin with you.
I guess my rating has a big old asterisk on it because you got to bring the pocket dog.
Mm.
But I have had it before when I did eat meat. I think it's exactly a 3.5 forker. It is exactly what you think you're going to get when you go there. And, you know, so it's right down the middle there.
Wow. Three forks, two tines. Solid score. Tammy Sager.
I think it is exactly what you think you're going to get. And that's kind of what you want, right? So it's I like how cheap it is. I like how fast it is. It was just, I like how no matter what bullshit you ordered, they were like, all right.
Yeah, it did seem like any combination works on this.
Yeah,
things.
They were cool. We'll
mayonnaise.
Do that.
There was mayonnaise. Did you do the mayonnaise?
No, mayonnaise was an option.
I'm going to give it, I mean, it's not good, but it is what it is. And I gotta give that 4.25.
Wow. Four forks one time. Wow. Very good score.
What other like? Are you sorry, Nick? You can host.
Thank you.
I'll do Nick. All right, very good score. All right, Hanford.
I just started talking. I didn't know Nick if that was
no. You, worse, could, so you could take. You took your own cue. That was great. I mean, that's totally fine.
We're having so much fun. This is just really. I'm
You're
not
so scared of him now.
I just get so nervous around Nick.
There's no reason to be nervous around me.
You're intimidating.
No, I'm a nice man.
You got a brain like a MacBook Pro.
I think it's just we're all realizing how scary AI is, and it's just like a lot more terrifying than we thought now.
Because I don't know. I've said a lot of things to him. I don't know how much he's banking.
Yeah.
Mike Hanford.
Okay. How are you, folks? How are we holding up? What other, like, hot dog chains are there?
Okay. Nathan's is one. Yeah, I mean, on the West Coast, there's Wiener Schnitzel.
Yep.
Those are closing, though.
Really?
There's the Dog House, which is a more upscale concept.
Okay.
But yes, that's a Sonic is one that I think people think of. Sonic Drive-In, not Sonic the Hedgehog, mm-hmm. that people think of as like a hot dog chain, yeah. even though that's just part of their menu. But yes, few and far between. There aren't as prominent as hot dogs are in the U.S. There aren't mm-hmm. as many hot dog fast food chains.
And there's they're not like burgers, which are everywhere.
Yes.
So I had a great time. I really liked what I ate. So I'm going to give Gray's Papaya.
Whoa.
Five pops.
Five.
Wow.
Wow.
Thanks, folks. I needed that.
It's gone up by 0.75 forks consistently.
Wait a minute, are you an AI too? What is this sparking back here?
What are you doing, Mitch? You're on your phone.
Mookie sent a picture of him and my mom and my sister at my house. He's at my house. Giving a thumbs up eating pizza.
Is that a proof of life situation?
you're getting sun cucked.
Is she gonna be at the show tomorrow?
Ooh, you do not want to see that next picture. Who, my mom?
Yeah.
She she'll be there.
Great.
Front row center, baby.
Really?
I only the best for mama.
Wow.
I don't want her to go. I told her not to go.
Oh, come on. I love your mom. That's what I was asking. I love seeing your mom.
She's great. She's
the best. You know, we'll hang out. We'll hang out with her.
All right. I want to hang out with her. Let's hear at the show and go home. I'm kidding. I love you, Mrs. Mitchell.
This guy came to my 40th. He came to my 40th surprise birthday party, Hanford.
A lovely gesture.
I teared up seeing him. I didn't know he was coming.
Yeah.
And he fucking blew the roof off the place. My sister was like, Hanford's so fucking funny. She was telling me that afterwards.
This was also at the end of the night when everyone was shithouse drunk. And I was like, whoa, I'm winning here. I was saying whatever. And people were like, oh. It was not good.
He was
That's,
on fire.
You know what? That's the big gulf between last night and this and tonight. Is last night people were absolutely fucking shithoused. The 9:30 club, they had two bars. People were fucking
drink
hammered.
The fuck up. What the fuck's going on out there? I thought this was New York City, for God's sakes. We're doing our best.
It's the city that never sleeps, but we're going to bed at 10:30.
I love this city, Wags. What a city.
Wow.
Wow. Wow.
You slept the whole time you've been here.
I was walking through Times Square earlier.
Yeah, to get to the show.
I heard Jay-Z's New York song not once, not twice, but three separate times on the way over. I said, this is a place I'd always love to be. Yeah, you knew that I always wanted to live here. I love this place. And to go to an institution-wise, Gray's Papaya.
Right.
A New York institution.
It's true.
And I think I should be put in a New York institution if I don't give it the correct score.
Who's got Bellevue on speed dial?
And if you want to know my score, look at the fucking hat. It's 5 forks, wise.
Wow. 5 forks.
Oh!
I fucking loved it.
Oh!
The orange drink was great. It tasted like a powdered orange drink. The pineapple juice, like Tammy, you said, tasted like they opened up a can of pineapples, took the pineapples out, and poured all the juice into a cup. That's also accurate.
And Mitch drank it and was like, this would be good for breakfast.
I knew that
whole
would
meal
come
or
back.
Just the juice?
The juice. Just the pineapple, like it was like
the sweetest.
Yeah, it was like almost gelatinous. It was so syrupy.
Hummingbird mornings. And the papaya juice tasted like sweet mac and cheese sauce, Wags.
Thank you.
But I loved it. I had a great time there, Wags. I could, and you know what? I was embarrassed that I got three dogs. Three dogs, simple meal there. I think if you don't get three, yeah, you're kind of a coward. Anyways, that's my score.
Wait, we never got back to him taking a bite from your dog. You said, well, we have to get to that.
Well, here we go.
Uh-oh.
Because, Mitch, you said that maybe you're a coward if you don't get three dogs. Well, you know what? I went back and I got another dog. I got a bonus Frank along with my coconut champagne. I got a Frank with just cheese. And that's how I remember getting it at Chelsea Papaya and it really, really clicking. And you know what? I think that was the best version that I had. I think there's just something about like, yeah, that chili to that cheese. And although it's decent chili, it's like a really thin sauce. It's kind of those two things on that small little dog. It's kind of unga pachka. I feel like I just need the cheese. And you had a bite of that cheese dog, and I think you agreed.
I loved it, Wags. It was my favorite dog.
It was so fucking good, and I'm glad I got to share it with my favorite guy.
Hell yeah. We love to see that, folks.
I'm your favorite guy?
Hey, you're up there.
Sonic tails me. I'm third.
You song.
Wags, you're one of my favorite guys.
Oh, Mitch.
I love you.
Yeah,
love
let's
Wags
land on one of for both of us. That's fine. That's
yeah,
safer.
One of you're one of,
you're
my,
one
favorite
of my favorite
guys.
Guys.
You know what? This is where I was going to sing. I was going to sing like, I need some ketchup and some mustard. I'm happy that I found out that was Creedence.
Yeah.
But I did it earlier because I thought that I needed to get the crowd going. And then yeah, I realized, just acoustics. It's just the fucking acoustics.
It's the acoustics.
It's
that's
the acoustics.
All it is. The acoustics.
Yeah, the acoustics.
The acoustics in here suck.
And yeah. Plays here usually. Is it usually mime shows? What is this venue?
Yeah, what is this venue usually used for? Anyways,
hold
Wags,
on.
What
I'm
is
just
your
getting it up on my phone. Oh, Marceau. Okay.
That's what
I
it
don't
is
know who that is. Marceau, am I?
No, you're right.
Wagger, take the reins here, my man.
I love what this
chain
doing
over there. He's playing snood.
I love what this chain represents.
You're playing snood?
And he's doing poorly.
I would never
you're
play.
You're playing snood when we're in front of a crowd
snood
of these paying
would never
audience
play.
Wait
fucking
a minute, some of these
snood
people have their phones out. They're playing snood, too.
Fucking New York.
No, I would never play snood because it's a low-rent clone of Bust a Move, the superior version, a.k.a. Puzzle Bobble.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't know that game. My ass is schooled here.
The guy just yelled Austin Power. Oh, did he want me to dance again? I'm not going to.
Maybe he was yelling out his own name.
I'm going to give I Graze Papaya. I love what it represents. Sure. I love that it's an institution. I love that it's so specific to the city, and I like all the clones as well. I feel like you go to any of these ripoffs and I have about the same amount of fun. So I am going to
How did you do that? Like it was very quick. It was like you knew. No, I know how
he didn't do that. I did it.
No, I know he did.
Okay, okay.
You use your tongue.
What I did, I accessed the memory bank in my brain that said, "Okay, that there's a song from that movie." That's not even the right movie, right?
No, that's Phantom Menace. Yeah. You could have done like the love theme from Attack of the Clones.
Yeah,
but
see,
that
wouldn't
people
know
recognize
that. I only
it
know
as well.
That.
Like,
yeah. I hate sand.
Zach, you told me he had a bad singing voice.
I'm sorry. I was just jealous.
I got here. For maybe you should have a sing off. I don't know.
Look, those
that
movies
didn't get
are
much traction.
Great.
Here we go.
And speaking of great movies, I'm going to give this the same score that I gave The Gray Man on Letterboxd.
Wow.
4.5
Wow.
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 So I'm the gatekeeper up here, I guess. I feel as if I've been set up.
No, not at all.
And I feel as if I've gone insane.
Well, wait a minute. You didn't
I thought 3.5 was going to be on the high end.
It's a good score.
You didn't even eat with the hot dogs. Who knows what's going on
Neither
with your score?
Neither did Tammy. She gave it 4.25.
Join us. Join us.
We'll see. I'll give it till the end of the show. We might have a score adjustment.
Wow.
The score might be amended.
Stay tuned. This is very exciting.
I'll say this.
You're hoping for a pretty epic burp, I think.
If Austin Powers were to dance one more time.
Oh! Whoa!
It might have an effect on the score.
Oh, shit.
We'll see if that happens.
Yes,
how about?
Yes,
we'll
see that's,
if
good, that happens. That's good, that's good,
that's But you know what? It's time for, that was our review of Grace Papaya. It's time for a segment. That's right, we've got some authentic New York cheesecake and some grocery store brands, and we're going to see if me and Mitch on our panel can tell the difference. It's cheesecake or cheese fake.
Ooh.
Well, this is
Start
exciting.
Spreading the cheese. I'm cheesing today.
Emma, do we have the cue?
Just
she's,
keep
she's
going.
She's telling me she needs a second.
Just keep going. You're doing great.
No, she's telling me she needs a second. We'll get to that. We'll get to the song in 1 second.
Why? Because I'm looking at the stage manager just shaking their head at you.
Hey, you know
but
what?
I'm going to say this. Last night we were in D.C.
Everyone at the Palladium has been great.
Everyone here kicks ass. Thank you to Palladium.
Awesome.
You guys
thank you
all
so
kick
much.
Ass.
I know you were in D.C. I saw the show.
Is that Hillary?
I don't know anymore.
We were at D.C. last night, and Emma gave me a backstage pass. She's like, you'll probably need this. And then I went out, and the guy backstage was like, who are you? And I was like, I'm in the show. And he was like, let's see credentials. I had to show him my credentials to go on the stage.
Immediately was like he called you out on it.
Yeah. It was
insane. No, because I knew that because the same thing happened to me because Emma gave it to me. And it was like a sticker. And like you were smart. You put it in your pocket. But I like stuck it to my pant leg. Yeah. And then, like, the sticker, like, kind of came off.
Yeah.
And so I ended up in a situation where, like, I'm trying to get to the stage. And the guy's like, who are you? You're supposed to be back here. Well, let me tell you your seat. I was like, no, I'm in the show. And he's like, oh, well, can I see some ID? I have to, like, take out my ID and show him that I'm the guy from the show. And he's, like, looking at my ID. He's, like, fucking grilling me.
Wow.
And he's like.
He was also standing 2 feet from backstage.
Two
like,
feet
that
from
was
backstage.
Crazy. Yes, we're coming from backstage.
Yes.
They did that to me and Jamel, too.
It's insane.
Insane.
And so he's like looking at my ID and he's like just making sure I'm not full of shit. He's like, what's your name? I'm like, Nick Weiger, and like on the thing. And he's like, I need your full legal name.
You fucking pulled the wool over your eyes, you fucking idiots.
And I tell this son of a bitch, my full legal name is Nicholas Frank Weiger, but sometimes I go by Frank, which means it's time for This Week in Hot Dog News and another edition of Let Me Be Frank. Hot dog, simmer in the city, Great Amile Grill getting greasy and gritty. Toast bun, don't it look pretty? Sucking on a dog like you're sucking on a titty. Pork and beef, sausages and long bread, rolling on a rolling grill, mustard and relish. One bite, it's a different world. Swap dog bites with a girl. Munch on and chop all night. Just fart the farts, it'll be alright. That taste, when the casing has snapped, later that day you'll for sure have to nap as you simmer in the city like you're sucking on a titty. You ain't nothing but a hot dog, frying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hot dog, frying all the time. You ain't never been a burger and you ain't no friend of mine. Well, they said you were a sandwich. Well, that was just a lie. Yeah, they said you a sandwich. Well, that was just a lie. You're just a bun around a wiener, so you sure don't qualify. Some of those that pork process are the same that cook sausage. Some of those that pork process, you're the same that cook sausage. Some of those that pork process are the same that cook sausage. Some of those that pork process, you're the same that cook sausage. Yeah. Grilling in the name of. Grilling in the name of. Now you chew what they told ya. And now you chew what they told ya. And now you chew what they told ya. And now you chew what they told ya. Now you chew what they told ya. Now your dog's on a roll. Now you chew what they told ya. Now your dog's on a roll. Now you chew what they told ya. Now your dog's on a roll. Now you chew what they told ya. 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 Frank, you I won't chew what you tell me. Frank, you I won't chew what you tell me. Frank, you I won't chew what you tell me. Frank, you I won't chew what you tell me. Frank, you I won't chew what you tell me. Frank, you I won't chew what you tell me. Frank, you I won't chew what you tell me. Frank, you I won't chew what you tell me. Frank and Ferdy!
Oh, oh, there's wardrobe changing.
Frank, open the door.
Hello, hi, I'm from True Life Church. Oh my God, what are you doing?
Read this to me.
What?
Please.
What?
Just read it.
What is this?
Just read it, read it, read any of it.
In the amazing book Moby Frank by the author Hervin Melgrill, the author recounts his story of being at lunch. In the first part of his book, the author, calling himself Dishmail, is in a small seaside cafe and he's sharing a hot dog with a man named Quee Dog. Why am I reading this?
Just read it. Read any of it. Just keep reading it.
And I felt saddest of all when I read the boring chapters that were only descriptions of hot dogs because I knew the author was just trying to save us from his old sad meal. Just for a little while.
Now I can die happy. I'm going to heaven.
Bye-bye, the dog. I love you. The dog instead of the whale.
The dog instead of the whale.
Wow.
Standing ovation. Standing ovation. Take it in.
Standing oh here.
Yes.
Wow.
Holy shit, that was phenomenal. I'm so glad I got to see you do that.
And just that to clarify, good. Does that mean there will be no cheesecake for us?
Yeah, we're not actually doing the cheesecake bit. We can get some afterwards.
That was awesome. Also, I really almost fucked the beginning. I'm sorry.
No, like, you were great.
It's crazy how they asked us for IDs.
No, that was perfect.
Oh, my God. That was amazing.
Mitch, you didn't have to actually open porn tabs on my computer.
I also didn't have to eat the meatball sub, but I certainly did.
Also, could you guys see? see that he was jerking off? Because I feel like that was behind the table.
I was jacking off.
Good. Okay.
All right, Mitch.
You know what, Wise? This oxygen helped me so much, I think I can do one more fucking Austin Powers.
Hey! Wow.
Wow.
There he goes.
I don't know.
Hell yeah.
Four forks!
Welcome to the Golden Plate Cup, Grace Papaya! Wow!
Woo!
Mitch, you were doing a little Dr. Evil, I think, there.
Oh, that might have been part of it.
What are you putting your... I'm saying...
I think I did, yeah. Okay. I think I did. So I think I fucked up.
You were doing also a little broken ankle for a second,
Yeah,
too.
You okay? You seem to twist something.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
All right.
All right, Mitch, this is Let Me Be Frank. Go ahead and Google hot dog news, and I'm going to search for it with my preferred search engine, Microsoft Bing. Here we go. All right, here we go.
Sounds pretty good.
You all right?
I'm out of breath.
I'll go first. Here we go. Let me see if we can find the news tab.
This is the most cows I've burned in a show.
Hey, Mitch, very perhaps on point for that. This is from Eat This, Not That. This was published yesterday. What happens to your body when you eat a hot dog?
Okay.
Often served at sporting events, barbecues, and other social gatherings, hot dogs are classic summer fare. As one of the most widely sold sausage products in the U.S., some may even argue that a cookout without a line of hot dogs in the grill is merely a basic outdoor picnic.
They needed to reach a word count because they're just describing the premise of a hot dog.
Oh, it continues. Because it says, hot dogs are made from ground-up cured beef or pork or both. The meat is then pushed into casings, which are twisted into sausage-like links.
Pushed in, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, this is a lot of unnecessary context. People know what a hot dog is.
It honestly does sound like AI.
It does. It might be.
I think it is.
You mean he sounds like AI.
And all this... All right. All this is a prelude to link to another article that is what happens to your body when you eat red meat every day.
Yeah, and this article is just one sentence. You dance like A. Powers. They couldn't even... They didn't have time enough for Austin?
Wags, I got one for you.
Wow.
Elizabeth Holmes can expect hot dogs, macaroni, and tacos in prison.
How fun. What a fun
combo. Sign me up. Hot dogs, macaroni, and tacos with my dream girl? That's fantastic.
Mitch, I'll see what I can do about getting a conjugal visit.
I love
you. She talked like that, right?
Wasn't
that
the thing? Okay. You did the female impersonator. You got your Hillary. You got your Holmes.
I'm trying to break some boundaries. But no one likes it.
This is from the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. This Fort Worth brewery is hosting its annual hot dog festival, introducing mustard beer.
Wow.
On Saturday, June 10th, Martin House Brewing and Fletcher's Corny Dogs celebrate Glizzies, or hot dogs, with its second annual Glizzy Fest and a new mustard-flavored beer. Fletcher's original Corny Dog mustard beer is a taproom exclusive, and the Star-Telegram was invited to try it out along with three other beers. And then it doesn't say what it just says we were invited to try it out, but it has no, like... additional information on how it tasted.
Hot dog news just ain't what it used to
be,
man.
It's not. It's fucking not.
Are you guys, I'm hearing Glizzy a lot more. Is that just because it's becoming popular? Have people been saying that for years?
Glizzy got in the lexicon fairly, I mean, like within the past decade.
But is it, okay.
It's from TikTok.
Oh, once Giannis said it on that commercial where he edits out the Glizzy, he says Glizzy gone. That's when I first heard it.
Can I tell you the craziest thing right now?
Please.
What's that?
I'm wearing Giannis's sneakers right now.
Are you really?
I play summer basketball. I need a new pair of sneakers. I got the
Giannis
Immortal 2s.
Wow.
Thanks, Tammy.
Those are sick as hell.
Those are fucking sweet.
They're nice. Wow, they're very comfortable.
I like him.
The Greek god.
Are you talking about me?
No. But I like, he like talks about how he to fuck his wife and
he's
like
very horny.
Kind of
he
like,
is very horny.
Yeah,
he's
too
like a
much
horny
for
wife.
Me. I don't
no,
like
no,
it.
No, but it's kind of like sweet.
Yeah,
right.
He's a Family Guy. No, it's. I think it's very wholesome.
Yeah.
He's very in love with his wife.
He's a what?
Okay, you take him and I'll do Lois. I guess I'm the new guy doing all that.
I'm the family guy. Yeah.
Wait, I'll do Stewie. I'm great at Stewie. My God, I'm gonna knock Stewie out of the park. Okay, so you go in with Peter the dad.
Yes. Okay. Did you say family guy?
Yes.
All right. I got an article.
Jesus Christ.
There's some I'm choking like the whale, for real. Oh, he
you
had a heart attack.
Did eat like half of a meatball.
I haven't eaten dinner yet, and it was actually kind of good, I will say. I will finish it. When I think, you guys should all, I want you to get fucking pissed off. The best hot dog is at this one hot dog joint in New Jersey.
Oh, get these three right in the front. New Jersey. I don't like these guys.
Fucking, you're letting New Jersey fucking take over the hot dog game. It's pathetic.
Are you the Jersey boys?
Wouldn't that be exciting if the Jersey boys were here?
The cast or what they were based on?
No, the actual guys.
Wow.
Joe Pesci was friends with them for real.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
in
unbelievable.
In the musical, he's a character in it.
Really?
Yes. 100%
that's
true.
Insane.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
They get up on stage and sing, "This show sucks shit."
When you said that, I thought you meant Joe Piscopo. Like, I heard Joe Piscopo, who's my New Jersey. Does anybody know who Joe Piscopo is?
He's probably friends with them, too.
Yeah, he probably
huge
is.
Fans, I guess. More. I am more of the meatball sub.
Let's do one more each because I want to have time for a Q&A. Looking for the Goldilocks of hot dogs. Here's what Consumer Reports recommends. This is from WTOP News. Known for its product comparison, the website Consumer Reports released its ranking of hot dog brands earlier this month. Having a catchy jingle didn't sway the judges who rated the hot dogs based on how snappy, juicy, flavorful, and smooth the meat was, both with and without toppings. Number one, I think this will play well. Nathan's Famous.
Ooh.
Number two, Hebrew National. Number three, Oscar Mayer. And number four, 365 Everyday Value, which is, I think, the store brand for Whole Foods.
Yeah.
Number five, Ballpark. I like a ballpark. Nathan's Famous. That's great. That's the one. That's the New York one.
You guys should figure out a way to go to the Nathan's hot dog eating contest. It's really fun.
Yeah?
I went a couple years ago. Has anyone been? It's great.
Are you a chestnut guy? You like Joey?
Yeah, I was there. I think he broke the record when I was there.
Wow.
Some say it was because I was waving to him the whole time.
Can I get your autograph after?
He's give me the fuck out of here. He hates me as he could.
All right, Mitch, you got one final one for me?
Well, Jamie Loft is our friend. Her book, it was
Raw
in the
Dog,
news.
Yeah.
Raw Dog's in the news, yeah.
A lot of fun. I got a copy.
I'm looking for West Coast Weenies, 72 years of corn dogs. That's exciting.
Y'all like corn dogs on the panel?
Love a corn dog.
Hell yeah.
And that settles that.
I mean, if it didn't have the dog in it, I'd be...
Like the batter.
I like... Yeah, who doesn't like fried batter?
Yeah, a lot of fun.
Okay.
Handman corn dogs?
Yes, I didn't know what we were doing. Yes, I like corn dogs. I like the mini ones that you can kind of... Because I don't like it on the sticker.
Oh, those are a blast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just pop.
I used to get those mini corn dogs from Costco. We'd have them like in the freezer at home, and then they would put
them
on
the plate. Let me guess. What was the count? 200?
All I need is... I just need a regular mayonnaise. I'm wheeling this thing out.
That's a good point.
Oh, Mitchie, he's hilarious.
Exactly.
I put those mini microwavable corn dogs on a plate, and then they cover them all with shredded cheese, and they put them in the microwave. It's fucking disgusting, and
yeah,
I love it.
Yeah, that sounds good. I would do that.
When I still smoke pot, my favorite thing to do was a Pepperidge Farm Sausalito cookies, which is the milk chocolate chunk. Macadamia nut, and then Reese's peanut butter cup, and you put that on top, and then you microwave it for like 12
Holy
to 14
shit.
Seconds.
That sounds
have like seven of those.
Wow.
Fucking, it was good.
That's good.
That rocks.
All right, I got one.
You got one, Mitchie?
I got the best vegan hot dog, Zach. I think this will work for you. There's the top 10 vegan
Let's
hot dogs.
Hear it.
Eggplant Ballpark Hot Dogs. 10.
Never heard of it.
9. Morningstar Farms Hot Dogs.
I don't think I've had it.
I think I've had Morningstar. They're okay.
8. Tofurky. 7. Upton's Naturals. That's a fucking dirty.
Watch it, Mitch.
No, those are. They're at,
do your it. Kate Upton impression.
Oh, that is the one I can't get. But I think it might sound something like this. One more hot dog, please. What? Actually, 2. One for me and my husband. Hey, pitcher.
All right.
Okay.
That's some specifics.
Yeah, pretty good.
6 TMRW. 5 Yeah Dog. 4 Light Life. 3 Jack and Annie's. 2 Field Roast.
That's the one I had. That's my favorite.
Field Roast. Field Roast. Yes, Field Roast. Yeah. That one's good.
Field Roast.
Yeah. Number 1. Roast. Pocket Dog. Pocket Dog.
Was that article recently updated?
This article was written today at 4 p.m. by the guy who told us where the line was.
Wow, is he here? He's not here, is he?
No.
Phew.
He was a random person who yelled at us.
I don't know. What if he like he just didn't recognize you guys because he listens to the podcast? He never had seen you guys before.
Totally possible.
Possible.
Here's some irony for you. This hot dog article written by Kat Smith.
All the Nickelodeon fans out there are going, what?
What?
Is that a cat dog reference?
Thank you.
There we go. God.
Thank you. You always got to be a step ahead when I'm around.
Cat dog is the only thing hotter than tail.
All right, that was Let Me Be Frank.
Which end are you getting with the cat dog, Wags? Where's the hull? Where the fuck's the hull?
Okay. Because there's two heads on each. It's a head on each end, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Give me the other version.
Jesus Christ. A monster made by the devil to be tortured by you?
Oh, my God.
He'd use flavored condoms. Don't worry.
All right. Hey, just like
do not bring up flavored condoms at the show tomorrow.
Oh, shit.
My mom's going to get fucking pissed. I don't want her to fucking hear it.
Has she heard on the podcast your jerk-off stories and stuff?
I hope not. I don't know.
That's crazy.
She's heard them. We live in the same house.
Do you narrate while you're going through it?
Hey, just like a restaurant, we value your feedback. Let's open up the feedback. We're going to take a few audience questions. Please welcome Emma Erdbrink back to the stage.
Oh, shit. We went long.
What's up? All right, I got Big Fudge. I'm very curious if that's your real name. Channing from the Snack Pack, Nora L., and Xander from the Right Mezzanine.
Wow. Make your way up towards Emma.
Oh, boy. Good luck.
Here we go. People are navigating their way up there.
What's up? Only 2 of them stuck around for the whole show.
No, people are coming from the back, too.
There's everybody.
Hey, guys.
Hey, what's up,
how's it going?
I'm here with my twin sister who works with Tammy.
Hey, Ryan.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
Her name's Ryan. She's awesome. She's funnier than cooler than me. So,
I thought you were about to say us. I was like, okay.
No, she, well, she
yeah,
is.
That too. Yeah, so my friends named their dog Spaghetti, but now every time they talk about Spaghetti the meal or like preparing it or listening to a podcast where the guys keep saying Spaghetti, the dog gets like super revved up. Knowing you might have to speak about said food in hushed tones, what food that you love would you name your dog after?
Wow.
Great question.
Wait,
great
remind
question.
Us your name again?
Channing.
Oh, you're
Snack
Channing.
Pack.
Of course.
Yeah,
yes.
Hey.
We talked to you on the Snack Pack more than
up?
Once.
Yeah. Also, I didn't come up with that question. That was my friend Madison. She came up with it. So.
What the hell?
She's... Yeah, she's funnier and cooler.
Channing, how's biking in the city lately?
It's good. I've been locked up like, you know, a block away, yeah. Biking through
Someone
Times
go steal
crazy.
His bike.
I like suspect that's gonna happen tonight. It's
oh,
fine.
Man.
Oh. Don't worry, people stay away from the Doughboy show. It's a ring of safety.
It's locked up next to Lion King, so.
Oh shit.
I don't know.
Watch out for Scar.
It's a great question. So the idea is like it's a But it has to be a food you love, right?
Yeah,
it's like a cop out
dog,
to say.
Right?
Yeah. Mm, fuck. What do you name a dog after a food where you have to say it in hushed tones?
I actually know a dog named Bagel. And
that's such a cute name.
Hoagie? Maybe Hoagie?
Hoagie's good.
Oh, Hoagie's good.
Hoagie's great.
Yeah, like a bulldog or something? Big slobbery bulldog?
Yeah, Hoagie.
It's my guy,
Ribeye. Give it a dog named Ribeye.
Oh, that's cute.
That's good, too.
Oh, I'm just picturing dogs now.
How about Salt? No, Salty.
Saltine?
Saltine.
Salty?
Salt.
Salty dog?
Salty?
Salty.
Salty? But this, I don't think that answers the prompt quite. Because, like, how often are you saying, what do you want to eat? Salty. It has to be like a food stuff.
I do say that at my place. I do. Pepper, then.
Pepper's cute. I think I might say something like ramen, because I feel like it would be fun to say in a hushed tone. Like, do you want to get some ramen?
I waffles.
Oh,
that's
so cute. And plural.
Yeah, waffles.
Oh, it's adorable.
I got one, motherfucker. Sorry.
I love that you go from salt. So, I got one motherfucker.
Dumpling.
Oh, that's good. Oh, that's so
that's
cute.
That's
I got
good.
A
pug
got
or something.
One. Edible condom.
Green apple.
But I wouldn't whisper that.
Yeah,
thanks,
Jenny. Never whisper that.
Thank you, guys.
Stay safe out there. Wear a helmet.
Be safe biking out there.
Wear a helmet. I hope you got a helmet.
Hi, what's your name?
My name is Nora.
Hi, Nora.
Hi.
From Queens?
No.
Damn
from
it!
From Brooklyn. My question is, if you had to adapt to the diet of any animal, including having to procure their diet, so if had to like hunt down that animal or whatever, what animal would you choose?
Do we also get their digestive abilities?
We
then I'm powers. Going.
You
I'm going.
Is the
staff you become
from the
animal,
Brooklyn
but
Zoo
yourself.
Here? What is this? What is this?
Yes.
Relax.
All right. I know. I told you I was gonna get wild.
I'm going goat because if you're a goat, there's about 15 meals sitting on this table here.
Oh.
This is food.
That's good.
This is food.
That's really
this
good.
This is food.
Goats. But then you want to eat that?
If you're a goat,
yeah, you do. You love it.
It'll sustain you. It'll be fine.
Yeah.
Oh, the goat's really good.
Goat's a great answer.
Goat's a great answer.
I guess I wouldn't mind being some sort of I'm just thinking of Avatar, and I think like just some sort of aquatic like being, like a tranquil sort of sea creature,
seafood.
Like a narwhal.
Yeah.
Because then I feel like I could I could enjoy the majesty of the ocean before it's completely ruined by man's avarice.
A fictional fictional thing.
I'm not saying I said a real animal.
Narwhals
are real.
Oh.
I didn't say a fictional animal from the planet Pandora.
Dude, I've never seen a narwhal.
I have never seen one in person either, but it seems like that'd be a cool animal to be.
Yeah.
Or an orca. Orcas are cool. Orcas are fucking sick as hell. I think I'm going with orca.
You want to eat
they're going
like
nuts
baby seals and stuff?
Well,
like,
no. I mean, look, I could do that as a man, but I don't do that.
What?
But
I
have to
exercise some restraint.
Do that as an orca. That's
not the brag you think it is, my man. I could eat a baby seal, but I don't.
I'd have some standards as an orca, but I think it'd be an orca. I think it'd be a majestic.
I don't like the life of a rabbit, but the idea that I would find vegetables delicious,
yeah,
it would be so good for me.
They're so cute too. It's like nibbling on a strawberry.
Just shitting nonstop.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Just so happy to just see green leaves. It's pretty cute.
I'd be the one rabbit that doesn't fuck. That sucks. I think I would go. I was in Costa Rica. I saw sloths.
Ooh. Wow.
In the mirror? Or
Tammy, you, FTW.
And maybe also seen a narwhal. I'm just going to say.
Fuck, you got me. You got me good. Tammy, it's fine. Everything's cool. I can do the Austin Powers dance if I got to again. Wally and Irma kind of have it made. I kind of like the way Wally and Irma eat.
They're sort of
So they like running don't they chew you? Your noodles?
I think you being
this
no,
is
Mitch,
well-worn territory. Mitch is going to eat the cats. We get it.
I think you being a domesticated feline is perfect for your lifestyle.
Yes, I wished I don't like cat food. I will say that. I'll go on the record. I don't like cat food. But if I was a Garfield type cat that could eat lasagna and things like that,
sure.
Then I think I would be happy with it.
So your answer is you want to be Garfield.
Yes, my answer is Garfield. Okay. A thing I got mad about Weiger saying a fictional character, the narwhal. My answer is Garfield.
Yes, okay. Great.
Thank you. Thank you, Nora. Boy, Mitch, you mentioned Nora from Queens. We had Nora from Brooklyn. There must be a Nora from all five boroughs. Manhattan, Queens, Brooklyn, the Bronx, and of course, Staten Island.
Oh, my God. I saw him practicing that in the mirror earlier.
I like the respectful distance. The questioners are like, it's like an ATM. Like, so far back. Like, I'm not looking.
Hi, what's your name? What's your question?
Hi, I'm Big Fudge.
Hi, Big Fudge.
Big Fudge.
That's a good dog name.
Fucking great dog name.
That is good.
Yeah.
Great man name.
Thanks.
Are you a dog that was turned into a man?
Great question, Mitch.
Yes.
Sweet.
I really wish my girlfriend was up here to ask this question for me.
Is she here tonight?
No. Okay.
Smart woman.
Yeah.
Zach, I'm a huge fan of Severance.
Thank you.
If you were severed in real life, what would you not want your innie to eat for lunch every day that would affect you as an outie when they left work after?
Huh.
Wow. Can we, this is only for Zach. We can't answer, correct?
This is for the panel.
Oh, all right.
I mean, the first thing that comes to mind is human shit.
That's the first?
Yeah.
That I don't want?
Yeah.
I don't want that. I don't want that. I don't know. Maybe I have a little more time to think. I'll come up with something else, but I don't know.
Thanks, Big Fudge. Great question.
When you said human shit, Big Fudge's face lit up. I think I know why he's called Big Fudge. I'd say any sort of hot, spicy peppers for me, because then I would be feeling it later.
Yeah, because that's the thing, because like if you're not remembering it, it's like something that you're going to feel the consequences of it later on.
Yeah, hot fudge.
Yeah, I guess for me it would be like my litany of food allergies.
Right.
And yeah.
I would just say like a lot of dairy. I wouldn't want to eat, like be binging, like having a lot of dairy, like a lot of ice cream. Because that's another thing, gastrointestinal after effects, I'll be dealing with that.
This is all stuff that you actually eat, though. I said human shit.
Oh, right. I don't eat that. I don't. I don't eat that. That's, none of us eat that.
Her fingers are crossed under the table.
I'm beating off like Mitch did in the whale. The dog.
Human shit is the answer. Thanks,
human
Big
shit.
Fudge.
Human
great.
Shit.
Thanks.
All right, one more question. Hi, what's your name?
Hey, I'm Xander.
Hi, Xander.
Hey, Xander.
Having a six dog day, actually.
Hell yeah.
Wow. Six dogs
Whoa.
Today.
There's a bar about 10 blocks up from Grace Papaya called Dead Poet, and I was there. Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah.
Wow.
It's always super crowded, but like today I was able to sit down because it was the middle of a Friday, and there's a thing on the menu that says, just over 50, Jimbo inhales dogs and ale. Wife looks mortified. And I'm like, excuse me, what the fuck is that? And they said, oh, you can try to eat 3 hot dogs and down a Pilsner. And if you can do it the fastest, you can have anything you want written up there. And
wow.
Jimbo is the guy who did it in just under 51 seconds.
Wow. 51 this, seconds.
Yeah. And so
is that's this a poetry gonna, that, jam. What's going on here?
Yeah, it's a haiku. It's a haiku. And so I tried it. And then after the first bite, it was like, oh, I can't do this.
Wow.
So I was wondering, like, if you think that, you know, you could do that, or how would you approach it?
It's three hot dogs and a beer.
Does that sound cool to you?
Three
guys,
hot dogs and like a full, like a Pilsner, like it's light, but it's a full beer, yeah.
Well, look, I mean, like, the pros do shit like they snap the dog in half and they separate the bun and they dip the bun. You can't
no
do
dunking.
That. No dunking. Okay. So that's off the table. I mean, I think I'm just like, I'm just fucking bolting those.
And then do the beer at the end.
I save the beer and I chug the beer at the end. Yeah, I think I'm just going to try to.
Jimbo did it.
Yeah, I think that's the only way I could manage that. Yeah,
plain,
bolt the three
plain
dogs,
hot dogs,
then chug the beer.
Plain hot dogs?
I put ketchup, mustard, ketchup, thinking it would matter at all, and it didn't. I just Ooh. It took me 1 minute to eat one of them, and then I'm just like, stop the timer. I'm just going to try to enjoy it.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I don't like, as much as I love food, I don't love food contests. I always feel like if they just the feat of endurance or whatever, I just like, I don't want to punish my body for glory. Let other people do that.
Let other people punish your body for glory.
I got cat dog, the headless cat dog.
What?
I'm saying that's who he punishes for glory. Oh. I think I would go bite. I would double fist.
Oh, two dogs.
Yeah.
That's nice because you'll feel like you're making progress, working your way through them.
Show us. Yeah.
Oh boy. Okay.
Can you smash them up into one kind of super dog and?
That's what I'm doing. Hey, this is pretty cool.
Wow, Mitch has
two mics.
Very cool.
Hey, two mics.
Hey.
Yeah, I'd probably just keep taking bites of each dog at once, back and forth. They should have given me two mics. I would have fucking killed tonight.
You're getting so much spit on the mic.
I know. I'm sorry.
He's putting it in his mouth.
You look like Immortan Joe.
Do not chase ladies down in my car. Here you go. I'll give you my mic back.
More like McFlurry.
You know what I would
Road.
Do? I would do it like.
What do you say, you piece of shit?
Huh?
I said more like McFlurry Road. Sorry, I keep going.
What would you do?
Can
Hanford?
I don't know if I can talk now or if
no,
Wagger's
please do.
Mad at me. Are you mad at me?
No one's mad at you. We love you.
You've been mad at Hanford the whole show.
Yeah.
What the fuck's
Why
been going on?
Why do you think
on?
I'm mad at Hanford?
No,
Hanford's
it was earlier
guy.
Grace Papaya. I came up to you. I had a funny attitude. You were there, right?
Yeah.
I was being funny. I said, hey, Wagger, you don't see big buildings like this in the Long Beach, do you? And you said, nope. And I said,
I was playing along.
And it's never
said,
been the same
on,
since
have
you did that.
Fun with me.
I was playing along. We were having a great time.
No, one of us
no,
was.
No, it was like I was being the Rube. I didn't have big cities in my town.
Yeah.
Maybe I played it too
straight.
I just wanted you
to say, yeah, they are big. Like,
I did think they were big, and I was impressed.
The buildings are tall here.
They're
okay.
tall here. We don't have them like that in Long Beach.
That's what I was saying.
It's not the same.
But you seem to be preoccupied with your hot dog order. I would eat the hot dogs like Slimer.
So, you'd get in the hot dog cart.
Yes.
And you'd come up and you'd have multiple hot dogs in your mouth.
Yes.
I think that's a pretty good move, honestly. Yeah.
Thanks.
Now I've pissed Hanford off. Way to go, Wags.
Xander, I think it's a great question, but fundamentally it's how would you eat three hot dogs and drink a beer? Which is like a normal activity, I feel like, for any of us.
Yeah, so actually, can I correct him? It was a really bad question.
I guess in the spirit of New York, Xander, no soup for you.
And don't shallow hal yourself. It's fine. It's not good.
Oh, shit.
It's good. It's good. It's fine.
Yeah.
It's good.
Green book yourself. I don't know what that means.
The audience acted strange.
Yeah,
to
I, as I said, I don't know what that means.
That's all right.
Emma, edit spot.
Perfect egg spot. Wait, the
so
end
your
of
strategy,
show.
Your strategy was you just like tried to eat the hot dogs as quickly as possible.
Once they told me when I got up to the counter that I couldn't do dunking.
Yeah,
I was thinking like chew, dip, chew, or chew, sip, chew, sip. And
yeah,
I just kind of spilled beer on myself and like, I looked like a baby. And then I finished one, and then I was like, "Don't look at
and
me."
And were they looking at who was looking at you while this is happening?
There were two guys in the corner, and then there was the bartender, and he was really invested. He had his hands on his hips, like.
Who was running the timer?
The bartender.
Yeah. Who were the two guys in the corner?
They were already having a conversation about hot dogs because they don't actually serve food there. They don't have a kitchen. It's one of those places you can get like a hot dog for $3 and they throw it on something. It was much worse than Gray's Papaya.
We can confess. It was the Doughboys. We like to watch. What were your other three hot dogs? That was a Gray's Papaya.
No, that was at Dead Poet this afternoon. Gray's Papaya, I had chili, mustard.
Well, you said you had a six-dog day, though.
Yeah, the first three dogs at Dead Poet. Yeah.
Okay, and the other three were at Gray's Papaya.
Coming here with my friends.
I feel like you're talking to your clone right now.
Well, why you're not hitting the math there? We got to reboot.
He's here to close my loop. fuck it, not worth the trouble.
He just kills me instead.
Thanks, Sandra. Thanks so much. Thanks to all of you. That's our show.
Thank you, New York.
Make some noise for Zach Cherry, Mike Hanford, and Tammy Sager, Emma Erdbrink, and thanks to Seagulls for our walkout music, seagulls.bandcamp.com. Until next time, for the Spoon Man, Mike Mitchell, I'm Nick Weiger. Happy eating.
See ya. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone.
And you know they can never be whack. The Fat Boys are back. Do you like it, the Fat Boys?
Want to dress like the Doughboys? Of course you don't. But you will want to wear our all-new Doughboys merch. Check out our completely revamped merch line in partnership with Kinship Goods. We've got high-quality shirts, hats, aprons, totes, and much more to come. Wow! Only at doughboys.kinshipgoods.com. That's KINSHIP goods.com. Sources for the intro are in the episode description.
That was a HeadGum Podcast.